Hello everyone, welcome to Operating Systems Lecture. This is another video for the memory management, that is unit number 4. And in this we are going to study the translation look side buffer, which is the TLB, that is the most important portion as far as the paging is concerned, and also some numerical examples of it, right? So see, this was the complete scenario that we have started in the previous lecture for your non-contiguous memory and paging. So again, I will be advising you that if you haven't studied that particular portion, then please go and first go to that video and then come back to this, because nevertheless you will be needing the previous knowledge in order to understand this. So the scenario that we have studied is that in address translation, we do this sort of mapping, that is the logical address space has been mapped to the physical address space, and we are just combining the offset together and just locating the address of the instruction, right? So what we have to do every single time, for example, CPU came and it says that I want to execute instruction number 8, so it will be checking the main memory to get to that instruction, that is the first arrow, that is the 8th instruction. Similarly, each time we will be manipulating or searching the page table, right, for in order to locate this page number 2, and again we will be searching the main memory to reach the particular frame number 3 and its first instruction. So anyhow, we are just searching the memory, and that will take time. So that is the excess time, that when exactly the X instruction will be identified or located. So that will take certain time. So that is the excess time, which was very large if in case the page table becomes the very large, right? So what we are trying to do is to reduce the excess time in paging. So we came into understanding that we can make use of a translation look-aside buffer, which is popularly known as TLB. So it can be used as a standard solution for this excess time problem, and it is a special small fast lookup hardware cache, which is known as translation look-aside buffer, that is TLB. So the TLB is an associative high speed memory, and it tries to reduce the excess effective time, and being a hardware, the excess time of the TLB is very less as compared to the main memory. So in order to understand what exactly a TLB is, just remember cache. Just like in the cache memory, what we do, we just store the frequently accessed item from the main memory into the cache. So every time that item is referred again, we do not go to the main memory, but we will be searching it or finding it in the cache memory, thus effectively reducing the access time. So what do? We just store our recently accessed pages. See, pages were in the frames, right? We are putting our pages into frames, right? So for in order to access a frame, we must have performed the complete address translation, right? So we just put those entry, we know the corresponding frame number because we have done the address translation. So that entry is put into the TLB, which is just acting as a cache. So if in the new future we will be again requiring that particular page number, so we, instead of checking the complete page table, will go to the TLB and just find out the corresponding frame number. So that will be reducing down the excess time, right? So that was the main motive. So in order to remember what a TLB is, so it's act as a cache in the paging. Now, talking about the hardware, the TLB is a hardware, so it will be consisting of two columns. One is the page number and it is the frame number. So you can view a TLB as a page table only, but a smaller size page table, and the underlying memory hardware is specialized, right? The main memory have a larger access time, but it is a cache sort of memory. So it is exactly the replication in terms of data of the page table, but a smaller in size and faster in terms of accessing, right? So it will be only having two columns, that is the page number and the frame numbers only, right? So this is the complete diagram which shows you the page table with a TLB hardware. So just look at the portions, what it says. When a CPU wants to locate an address or an instruction, it generates the logical address, right? That is the combination of your page number and the offset, right? So that is the logical address. So now instead of checking the entry of that logical address into the page table, what we do, we first check that data in the TLB, that is the translation lookaside buffer, that whether might be possible, we will be checking if it is a recently accessed page. So if it is a recently accessed page, then its entry must be in the cache, right? That is in the TLB. So we first go to the TLB. Now, if suppose we find that entry in the TLB, then that is known as a TLB hit, right? So if we find the entry in the TLB, that is a TLB hit, and we definitely will get the corresponding frame number, and we will be combining it with the offset, and we can refer the data into the, or the instruction into the physical memory. But suppose it's a TLB miss, that is, we searched the complete table of TLB, but we didn't find the entry of that page number. So then again, what we'll be doing, we will be referring our original page table, and of course that will be getting the entry in it, and then we will be combining it with the physical address, and we can be locating the instruction into the physical memory. So what we do, we first check our TLB, and if we find that element in the TLB, we find the entry of the page table, that is a TLB hit, otherwise it is known as a TLB miss. So that is the important diagram which you have to understand and write it down if there is a question on TLB. Mostly the question on TLB is write a short note on TLB, otherwise you will be getting a numerical portion in it, right? So that was the paging hardware with TLB. The next thing is some important points that you need to understand, that what a TLB exactly have in it. So it is unlike the page table, there exists only one TLB in our system. See, each process has its corresponding page table, right? So if I have 10 processes in the memory, so I will be having 10 page table also in the memory, right? But as far as the TLB is concerned, because it is a hardware, so it is only one structure. So it will be having entries of recently accessed pages from different programs or processes, right? So what happens with TLB, that whenever a context switch occurs, the entire content of the TLB will be flushed out or deleted, and again the TLB is updated for the currently running process, because we know that context switch happens in our with the CPU, because CPU will always be changing its context, right? So every time there is a context switch, the data which is written in the TLB has been deleted, and again when the new process is brought up into the memory, then further the new entries in the TLB continues, right? And a TLB contains only a few page table entry. Obviously it is a replica of page table, but it is a smaller in size. It has certain recently accessed page table entries. Then what we need to know, that if a page is found, that is a TLB hit that we have already seen in the diagram, and if the page number is not found, it is the TLB miss, and then the reference to the page table is made. Now the percentage of time that a particular page number is found in TLB, that is known as the hit ratio. For example, an 80% of hit ratio means that we find the desired page number in the TLB 80% of the time. Initially, the page table is empty, so the hit ratio is low, but eventually when the entries or the recently accessed pages number increase, then the hit ratio also increases. Now, these are certain important formulae that you need to understand in order to do the numericals related to page table or TLB, and remember these formula and the problems of numerical problems will be very easy to solve. So what the question is asking about the numericals, it says you to find the effective memory access time with TLB and without TLB, and the comparison between the two, right? So of course, if we do not have TLB, then the time taken will be more, and if we apply TLB, because of the hit ratio, the effective time will reduce down. So that is the calculation that we have to do. So the formula says that effective memory excess time is equals to hit ratio, which is multiplied by the excess time of the TLB plus the excess time of the memory. Remember, with hit ratio, what happens? We are finding the item in the TLB. So we will be searching the TLB. So hit ratio into excess time of TLB. हम TLB को search कर रहे हैं. Plus TLB में data मिलने के बाद, we are going to the physical memory और physical memory को search कर रहे हैं. So that will be the excess memory time of the physical memory plus the time searching of the TLB into the hit ratio. Talking about the miss ratio, we are not finding the data into the TLB, but we have accessed the TLB also. Miss ratio के लिए भी हमने TLB को सर्च किया था, right? TLB को सर्च किया और उसके बाद फिर हम कहाँ पर आए? पेज टेबल को सर्च करा एंड देन वी गेट टू द फिजिकल टेप द फिजिकल मेमोरी, राइट? सो मिस रेशियो इनटू द टोटल एक्सेस टाइम. देयरफॉर द टोटल एक्सेस टाइम इज इक्वल्स टू एक्सेस टाइम फॉर द टीएलबी, बिकॉज हमने टीएलबी को तो सर्च करा ही है एंड वी हैव सर्च द मेमोरी ट्वाइस, वेयर वी हैव सर्च द फिजिकल मेमोरी एंड वी हैव सर्च द पेज टेबल, राइट? सो वी हैव ऑल्सो एक्सेस द पेज टेबल इज अगेन इन द मेन मेमोरी ओनली. सो वी हैव एक्सेस द मेमोरी ट्वाइस. Just revise it again. Effective memory says hit ratio. Hit ratio means we have searched the TLB and then we are searching the physical address, right? Miss ratio, we have searched the TLB. We didn't find the data in TLB. We searched the page table and again we searched the main memory, right? Physical memory. So the access time will be TLB time plus twice the main memory. And remember that hit ratio is a percentage, so it's always be less than one. Right, because obviously there are few entries in the page table, right, in the TLB, so it's always been less than one. So let's understand this particular question. So if it takes 20 nanoseconds to search a TLB and 100 seconds to access the memory, then a mapped memory access takes 120 nanoseconds when the page table is in TLB. If we fail to find the page in the TLB, then we access the page table and the desired byte in the memory total is of 220 nanoseconds. Now, what is the effective memory access time with the hit ratio of 80%? So let us see what this question is saying. It says that हमें TLB को सर्च करने में 20 नैनो सेकेंड्स लगते हैं और फिर उसके बाद अगर हमें टीएलबी में डेटा मिल जाता है तो मेन मेमोरी को सर्च करने में 100 नैनो सेकेंड्स लगते हैं, राइट? इफ देर इज अ मैपिंग ऑफ एड्रेस टेक्स प्लेस देन इट टेक्स 120 नैनो सेकेंड्स व्हेन द पेज नंबर इज इन द टीएलबी, राइट? सो इट विल टेक 120 नैनो सेकेंड्स व्हेन इट फाइंड्स द पेज नंबर इन द टीएलबी. बट अगर टीएलबी के अंदर हमें पेज नहीं मिलता है तो हम पेज टेबल को एक्सेस करते हैं, राइट? और फिर उसके बाद मेमोरी को एक्सेस करते हैं, तो टोटल टाइम पेज टेबल और मेमोरी को एक्सेस करने में 220 नैनो सेकेंड्स लगता है, राइट? सो हिट रेशियो इज 80%. सो यू कैन सी दैट इन द फॉर्मूला 0.08 इज योर हिट रेशियो, राइट? अब हिट रेशियो के साथ हमारे पास टाइम आता है. हिट रेशियो मीन्स डेटा कहाँ मिला? टीएलबी में. तो टीएलबी को सर्च करा होगा, तो टीएलबी को सर्च करने में 20 नैनो सेकेंड्स लगते हैं, राइट? टीएलबी को सर्च करने के बाद अगर हमने खाली मेन मेमोरी फिजिकल मेमोरी को सर्च करा है तो उसके अंदर कितने टाइम लगा? 100 नैनो सेकेंड्स लगे, तो उतना डेटा लिखा. प्लस मिस रेशियो, मिस रेशियो इज 1 माइनस हिट रेशियो. तो इफ इट इज 0.8 देन इट विल बी 0.2 मिस रेशियो. तो मिस रेशियो इनटू अगर हमें डेटा टीएलबी में नहीं मिला तो हमने क्या हुआ? मिस रेशियो हुआ हमारा, राइट? तो मिस रेशियो लिखा इनटू, फिर हमने क्या करा, यहाँ पर चेक करा अपना पेज टेबल और पेज टेबल से गए फिजिकल मेमोरी पे. तो पेज टेबल और फिजिकल मेमोरी दोनों को मिला के कितना टाइम लग रहा है? 220 नैनो सेकेंड्स, राइट? सो वी जस्ट पुट इन द डेटा इनटू द फॉर्मूला एंड दस द आंसर इज 140 नैनो सेकेंड्स. तो जस्ट रिमेम्बर द डायग्राम दैट वी हैव स्टार्टेड इन टीएलबी एंड विद दैट डायग्राम यू कैन सॉल्व दिस पर्टिकुलर क्वेश्चन. लेट अस चेक अनदर क्वेश्चन. इट सेज कंसिडर अ सिस्टम वेयर टीएलबी एक्सेस टाइम इज 60 नैनो सेकेंड. सो वॉट इट इज द टीएलबी को सर्च करने में टाइम कितना लग रहा है हमको? 60 नैनो सेकेंड. नाउ वॉट हिट रेशियो इज रिक्वायर्ड टू रिड्यूस द इफेक्टिव मेमोरी एक्सेस टाइम फ्रॉम 300 नैनो सेकेंड्स विदाउट टीएलबी टू 250 नैनो सेकेंड्स विद टीएलबी. फाइंड द हिट रेशियो, राइट? सो इट इज सेइंग दैट वी आर टेकिंग 60 नैनो सेकेंड्स टू सर्च द टीएलबी. तो अब हमें ये बताइए कि हिट रेशियो हमारा कितना पहुंचे कि जो हमें बिना टीएलबी के टाइम लग रहा था वो 300 नैनोसेकंड्स लग रहा था, तो हम उसको रिड्यूस कर पाए 250 से. ठीक है, सो व्हाट इट इज द गिवन डेटा इज दैट द टाइम टेकन बाय टीएलबी इज 60 नैनोसेकंड्स. नाउ विदाउट टीएलबी वी आर टेकिंग 300 नैनोसेकंड्स, राइट? तो अगर टीएलबी नहीं है तो सर्च किस किस जगह को करा? सर्च करा पेज टेबल को, तो एक बार मेमोरी सर्च करी. उसके बाद फिजिकल मेमोरी को सर्च करा, तो दो बार मेमोरी सर्च करी. दैट इज 300 इज इक्वल्स टू 2 × द एक्सेस टाइम, राइट? तो हमने मेन मेमोरी को कितनी बार सर्च करा? दो बार सर्च करा. तो हमें पता लगाना है कि मेन मेमोरी को सर्च करने में एवरेज कितना लगता है. तो दैट इज 300 इक्वल्स टू 2 × एक्सेस टाइम, सो दैट इज 150 नैनोसेकंड्स, राइट? एंड नाउ वी हैव द टाइम टेकन बाय द मेन मेमोरी टू बी सर्च, दैट इज 150. सो लेट द हिट रेशियो बी इक्वल टू एक्स एंड देन अगेन पुट द डेटा इन टू द फॉर्मूला. इट सेज इफेक्टिव मेमोरी टाइम हमें कितना चाहिए? 250. तो 250 इक्वल्स टू, हिट रेशियो पता नहीं है एक्स, देन टीएलबी को सर्च करने में लगा 60 प्लस 150, एक बार मेमोरी को सर्च करने में लगा, दैट वी हैव कैलकुलेटेड, राइट? सपोज अब टीएलबी में नहीं मिलता है डेटा तो मिस रेशियो जाएगा, दैट इज 1 − x, राइट? और उसके बाद अगर हमें डेटा नहीं मिलता है तो एक बार वी विल बी सर्चिंग द पेज टेबल विच इज इन द मेमोरी एंड देन वी विल बी सर्चिंग आर फिजिकल मेमोरी, राइट? सो दैट विल बी ट्वाइस वी विल बी एक्सेसिंग इट, सो इट विल बी 300 ओनली, राइट? सो इनटू टोटल एक्सेस टाइम, राइट? तो दैट विल बी 60 प्लस 360, बिकॉज हमने टीएलबी भी सर्च करा, टीएलबी में नहीं मिला तभी तो मिस हुआ था. सो दैट विल बी वी आर एडिंग 60 प्लस 300, अगेन सॉल्विंग द इक्वेशन एंड वी विल बी गेटिंग द एक्स इक्वल्स टू 0.7.0.73, दैट इज 73%. अगेन द एडवांटेजेस एंड डिसएडवांटेजेस ऑफ टीएलबी व्हिच इज वेरी easy to understand, that is TLB reduces the memory access time obviously, and only one memory access is required when TLB hit happens, that we have seen. But it also has certain disadvantages, that is because whenever context switch happens the TLB gets deleted and it's again refilled, so it will be taking a considerable amount of time. Of course that will be negligible, but still there is a time lag. Then a TLB can hold data for only one process at a time, and it of course requires a special hardware because TLB is a hardware cache memory, so it will require additional cost in order to make the complete hardware memory system. So that were certain disadvantages that were associated with TLB. But as far as your numericals and the theory portion is concerned, the university will ask, write a short note on translation lookaside buffer, and the two different types of numericals that we have covered are more than sufficient in as far as your university examinations are concerned. I hope that this particular topic of TLB will be clear to you all, and for any doubt feel free to ask in the comment section. Thank you.